I have a question for you. Do you know what you're carrying? In the book of Exodus 3, God and Moses were having a discussion. Moses had just encountered God at the burning bush. And God was giving Moses instruction as to what he wanted him to do. He was telling Moses that he would be the one to lead the Israelites out of bondage. Moses, he couldn't see himself doing that. So he let God know that, no, I'm not cut out for that job. Not me. You've got the wrong person. I'm not capable. I can't do that. As the conversation progressed, and Moses continued to tell God why he was not able, God changes the subject. And he asked Moses, "What is that in your hand?" Moses replied with a natural answer. "A rod," he said. And God told Moses to throw the rod to the ground. And when Moses did that, that rod became a snake. This frightened Moses. He'd carried that rod for years, and it had never done that. God would go on to tell Moses all of the things that he would use that rod to do. You see, that rod would be utilized to command the Red Sea to split in half, allowing the Israelites to cross over onto dry ground and into their freedom. But it took God showing Moses just what he was carrying before any of this could take place. And what is it with you? You're listening to this recording, and God has asked you to do something. But just like Moses, you're telling God, "No, I'm not the one. I'm not good enough. I'm not strong enough, God. I'm not smart enough. I'm not popular enough. I'm just not enough. I'm not enough. I'm not enough." But God is saying to you, that you're an overcomer. You are an overcomer. Even though your mind is telling you that you're an underdog, God says you can't be an overcomer and an underdog. You've got to pick one. And God is telling you what you really are. You see, in 1 John 5:4, it assures us that whoever is born of God overcomes the world. There's that word, overcome. You're an overcomer. And so knowing that, I ask the question, do you know what you carry? You see, Moses was carrying that rod around, and that rod had no significance to him because he didn't know what he was carrying. And as you look at yourself, you see yourself and you don't see the significance. You have no idea. Because when you see you, you don't see what God sees when He looks at you. What is it that you are carrying? Are you carrying something that will carry others to freedom? What do you carry? Do you carry something that will take people from their wilderness? To their promised land? What is it that you carry? Are you carrying something that will take people from a place of devastation to celebration? What are you carrying? Are you carrying something that will carry someone else from tragedy to triumph? Please understand that what God has placed on the inside of your being bears the fingerprints. The fingerprints of the one who made you. Yes. You carry something so great that it carries the glory of El Shaddai. What you carry is so profound that it will astound you. And I know you think of yourself as ordinary, but I need you to know that God is extra. And when He pairs His extra with your ordinary, something extraordinary happens. Something extraordinary. soak in His presence. Just soak in the presence of God. Soak in His presence. Relax in God's presence. Ask God what you carry. Because what you carry is greater than your burdens. It's greater than your fears. It's greater than your past. It's greater than your doubts. It's greater. Greater. It's greater than your worries. It's greater than your tears. It's greater What do you carry? What do you carry?